Ah, the intoxicating smell of the graveyard. Once a year, we gather beneath our family tree to honor the great cycle of life and death. Come, every member of our clan, living, dead, and undecided, and let us celebrate what it is to be an Addams. Come to me, my luscious wife. Oh, she of skin so pale, eyes so black, and dress cut down to Venezuela, and tell us what it is every Addams hopes for.
Darkness, grief, and unspeakable sorrow.
I love it when you talk sexy. When you're an Addams, you need to have a little moonlight. When you're an Addams, you need to feel a little chill. You have to see the world in shades of gray.
All 50.
You have to put some poison in your day.
That's the way when you're an Addams.
You need to have a sense of humor.
Ha.
When you're an Addams,
you need to have a taste for death.
Who cares about the world outside and what it wants from you? When you're an Addams, you do what Addams always do.
Mi amor.
Will you love me forever and ever?
We shall be as besotted with each other as the night we met.
Our first date you took me to see.
Death of a salesman.
How we laughed.
When you're an Addams,
you gotta have a lot of passion.
When you're an Addams,
you need to really love your wife.
Every hour on the hour.
You're happy when your toes are in the mud. You smile a bit the moment you smell blood. When you're an Addams,
you need to grab a bow and arrow.
When you're an Addams,
you need a moment to explode.
Just pour a potion.
Flip the switch and wait till things get hot. When you're an Addams,
you have to really stir the
pot. So give us shadows, give us gloom. Broken glass in a motel room. Something fun we can all exhume and give it all tonight.
And now we summon our beloved ancestors. Why do we do this?
Because, living or dead, family is still family.
Yes, and how do we do this?
By dancing on their graves.
Yes, dance, my brother Fester. Time to wake the dead.
Once torn asunder, down 6 feet under, we get together here. Dead for forever, bled from whatever, called now to reappear. Every cadaver starts a palaver once in an Addams year. Hold your decaying, hear what we're saying, time now to give a cheer.
Lion dance. Bunny hop. Do the twist. Rigor mortis. Death rattle.
When you're an Addams,
that's right. When you're an Addams,
special dudes late night, out with the animals.
When you're an Addams,
with one bite, you're obligated to the clan. It's family first and family last, and family by and by. When you're an Addams, the standard answers don't apply. When you're an Addams, you do what Addams do or die.
Until next year, my beloved ancestors, back to your crypt.
That's right. We have a problem.
His name is Lucas. Lucas Beineke, and I'm in love.
That's right. Little Wednesday Addams, that charming, irrepressible little bundle of malice who would poison her own brother just for the ride in the ambulance, has grown up and found love.
Oh, Wednesday, I just want to lock you up in a little cottage with a white picket fence and an apple tree.
I like the part about being locked up.
So here's the deal. Gather around. I'm not letting you back into that crypt until love triumphs.
What? Wait, hey, who is this Lucas fella anyway?
Is he worthy of her?
Do they, I'm worthy.
Do they really love each other?
Of course not. They're just kids.
What is love anyway?
The wind in your hair.
It's your toes in the sand.
It's the feeling of someone holding your hand.
Love.
Love requires obstacles to be true.
It's a force to commitment.
Love requires grit.
And then you know it to be true.
Wait, wait, wait. Hold on. Hold on. Does this trash look serious to you?
Yes. But when you think about it, is there anything more important than love? Let's not talk about anything else but love. Aww, let's not talk about anything else but love. Can't we talk about lofty goals, mating souls, altering minds and faltering roles? Let's not talk about anything else.
Fight, sir, fight like a man. Feel the kiss of my Spanish steel. Ha! 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 I've foiled again. Darn your lightning reflexes.
Gomez, look.
Ugh, flowers! Who would send something so tasteless?
The most precious gift there is, more goody-licious than gold, is that blessing we call friendship, whether new or very old.
Goody-licious, who talks like this?
The Beinekes. Wednesday's friend Lucas and his parents, they're coming for dinner tonight.
Lucas?
Yes?
But Lucas is a boy's name.
Yes?
Wednesday has a friend who's a boy.
It's nothing, darling. Puppy love. Put these in water.
Mom, Dad, I shot dinner.
Oh, Wednesday, that's lovely. Wherever did you find it?
Petting zoo.
Thank you, dear. Come, Larch, we'll whip up something really special for dinner. And this time, we'll actually cook it. Oh, Gomez, guests for dinner, fresh meat.
Daddy, I have something very important to tell you.
What is it?
Can you keep a secret?
Of course.
Look.
If I'd know any better, I'd say that's an engagement ring. What are you saying?
Oh, Daddy, Lucas wants to marry me.
What?
Lucas Beineke loves me, and he wants to marry me.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes. I think so.
You think so?
Well, I never even met his parents, and he's never met mine, and I just need to be sure.
That he's the one.
That the families can get along. I mean, he has to know what he's getting into.
What are you saying?
I'm saying we're who we are, and they're from Ohio.
Ohio! A swing state!
That's what I meant.
You're right, this is important. Let's go tell your mother.
No!
No, you don't want me to tell your mother?
Oh, please, Daddy, she'll ask a lot of embarrassing questions and wreck the whole thing.
But we have to tell your mother.
After dinner and we're all friends, then we'll tell her.
But I've never kept anything from her before.
Daddy, please.
Yeah, but
if you love me.
Yes.
Do you love me, Daddy?
There are two things I would never do. Say no to my wife. Say no to my daughter. So what exactly should I do? Do you realize what you're asking me to do?
Daddy, one tiny secret. Please, please.
Okay, I promise I won't tell your mother.
Thank you, Daddy. Our little secret, though, right?
Yes, our little secret. Wednesday's growing up, but I'm not ready. Wednesday's growing up as time slips by. When did she become someone else's chum? Someone else to make her father wonder why Wednesday's growing up. She'll be Thursday before you know it.
Something's wrong with Wednesday.
What do you mean?
She's in the kitchen smiling like this. Maybe it is this boy.
This boy? Don't be silly. You yourself said it. Puppy love. Ha, I say. Double ha. Ha ha. Come, darling. I feel an urge to take you in my arms. Let's go upstairs.
Gomez.
On the other hand, she's a healthy young woman like you were. Are. Like you are. And she could even grow up and fall in love and get married just like you did.
Don't be ridiculous, Gomez. I'm much too young to have a married daughter.
Of course, I didn't think of that.
Besides, she'll have lots of boys.
How do you know?
Because she's my daughter.
Yes, but what if, and I have absolutely no reason to say this, what if she did meet a boy who stole her heart?
Don't be silly. When that happens, I'll be the first to know. Wednesday tells me everything, just like you do.
There are three things I would never do. Lie to my wife, lie to my daughter, or tell the truth to either one.
Gomez, you do tell me everything, don't you?
Of course.
Oh my, you're perspiring.
What?
I hope you're not coming down with a case of liar shingles.
No, liar shingles, of course not. I'd never know.
I think Wednesday and I should have a little chat.
Okay. Like a bull in a ring, like the moderate right wing, I'm trapped. Like a fly in my tea or the Frisco DMV, I'm trapped. With my wife to my left and my daughter to my right, any thought of my escaping must be scrapped. I could choose sing the blues, but no matter what I do, I'm trapped, trapped, trapped. Like a boat in a lock or a cuckoo in a clock, I'm trapped. Like a corpse in the ground or like theater in the round, I'm trapped. I could cry, I could lie, I could simply up and die, but I fear the dice I've rolled have finally cracked. Should I beg, should I rage, or stay safely in my cage? How trapped, trapped, trapped. How can I keep a secret from the woman I adore? The bitter breeze that keeps me here and coming back for more. She stokes the Addams fire. She harbors his desire. I never tell her lies. But when my daughter cries, how can I be expected then to turn the other cheek? Should I not be her hero instead of sniveling and weak? I'll pick a route that's true. Show me what I must do. Should I gripe? Should I groan? Would I rather pass a stone? Trapped. Wife gone wild, crazy child, little me unreconciled, I'm trapped. If I'm wrong, I'll be strong and we'll try to get along. Or I'll fail, have to bail, show my coffin to the nail. If I snapped, maybe dinner would be scrapped. Then I wouldn't be trapped. Trapped. Trapped.
Wednesday and Lucas sitting in a tree. K-I-L-L-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes... Ah! Wow, that was intense. Do it again. Ah!
The sinner has to go okay.
It will if you let me blow up this Lucas guy.
Oh, Pugsley, ever since I met him, I want to laugh and cry, and everything seems right and wrong at the same time, and then sometimes I just want to rip his flesh off and eat him up until there's nothing left.
You.
I don't have a sunny disposition. I'm not known for being too amused. My demeanor's locked in one position. See my face, I'm enthused. Suddenly, however, I've been puzzled. Bunny rabbits make me want to cry. All my inhibitions have been muzzled, and I think I know why. I'm being pulled in a new direction, and I think I like it. I think I like it. I'm being pulled in a new direction. Through my painful pursuit, somehow birdies took root. All the things I detested, impossibly cute. God, what do I do?
Wow, you got some real issues.
Fly away, little birdie. Mother always said be kind to strangers, but she doesn't know what they destroy. I can feel the clear and present dangers when she learns that the boy has got me pulled in a new direction.
Ah!
And I think I like it.
That was good.
I think I like
it. Do it again.
I'm being pulled in a new direction.
Ah!
And this feeling I know is impossible, so I'll confide that I've tried, but I can't let it go. It's disgustingly true. Cold. Puppy dogs with droopy faces, unicorns with dancing mice, sunrise in wide open spaces, Disney World, I'll go there twice. Butterflies at picnic lunches, bunches of chrysanthemums, lollipops and pillow fights, and Christmas Eve, sugar plums, string quartets and chia pets, and afternoon banana splits, angels watching as I sleep, and Liberace's greatest hits have got me pulled in a new direction. If they keep insisting, I'll stop resisting. Just watch me pulled in a new direction. I should stay in the dark, not obey every spark. But the boy has a bite better far than his bark. And you bet I'll buy to do what's truly taboo. As I'm pulled in a new direction.
I was right. It is the boy. Puppy dogs, Disney.
A world.
She is in no state to entertain guests. We have to cancel the dinner.
No.
What?
I mean, we can't do that.
Why?
Because then there won't be dinner.
Gomez, do you love your daughter? Do you care for her mental well-being? Do you want to see her put on heavy medication and spend the rest of her days hating us because we let her ruin her life?
There are four things
Gomez! Would you stop that?
We need to have this dinner.
Why?
To introduce her to the world.
Are you out of your mind? Have you seen the world lately? Now, stop prattling and go tell her the dinner is off.
Gotta.
You're the father. The father is the counselor. And if after 25 years of marriage, you can't do this one thing for me, then, you know, I just don't know what. I mean, honestly, what did you think you were going to do? You know.
Oh, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Faster, faster, move, 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 faster, faster. Okay, so about tonight. Now here's the schedule. First, we'll have drinks like, hi, nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Good. Yes. Then they'll want to see the house, and then at 8:30 we can have dinner and they can be back at their hotel
Wednesday?
By 9:30.
Your father has something to tell you.
Paloma, your mother and I are having second thoughts.
About what?
This dinner, it all seems so
quick. It's not! Quick. Daddy, it's just a simple dinner and they're dying to meet you. And plus, I promised Lucas, and you know how much I hate to break a promise.
Yes, Paloma, but your mother and I...
Daddy, I'm your eldest child and your only daughter. And if you can't do this one thing for me, then... I just don't know what.
Maybe just a little dinner?
Thank you, Daddy!
Well, it seems I've been outvoted. So, dinner it is then. Drinks, dinner, and then the game.
Oh, God, please, no, not the game.
But it's a family tradition.
But it's my dinner.
But it's my house, darling. Dinner and then the game.
One out of two, Paloma, don't push it.
Fine, then can we at least all act normal?
Define normal?
Darling, normal is an illusion. What's normal for the spider is a calamity for the fly.
Mother, please. There are normal people not like you, not like me. Please, can't we be an average family? One normal night, that's all I want, that's all I need from you. One normal house without a mouse to feed a plant or two. You must admit we're not what people call laid back. So can't we muse a bit and lose the basic black? Whoa, one normal night with normal people on their way. Just one normal night. What do you say?
One normal night.
To be polite, to do the least you can.
One normal eve.
Can you achieve a kind of common man? You had to swear to me, yes, promise to the core. It's almost 6 o'clock, they're almost at the door. On all the Addams ancestors who've ever walked the right.
Lucas? Lucas? Where are you? Look. There you are. Lucas! Enough is enough. Give me the map!
I don't see any houses.
That's because there aren't any, dear. We're in the middle of some godforsaken park.
Golden Gate Park, dear. Designed in 1847 by John...
Wait!
What?
What?
I know where we are. This is where I first saw her. I was lost in the park and a pigeon dropped at my feet with an arrow in it. I looked up and there she was. Wednesday with a crossbow.
With a what?
A crossbow. You know.
This girl walks around with a crossbow?
It's okay, Dad. She has a conceal and carry.
Oh, good. Good choice, son. Now listen up. Here's what's going to happen. We're going to walk right back to that hotel, and you and I are going to have a little talk.
Be patient with him, dear. A father should support his son, and Lucas is your only one.
You see what you did? Your mother's rhyming again. This is why I said we should go back to the hotel, and then...
No! Normal night, no, not one poem, not one inspiring word. One normal scene, complete routine. Tonight can't be absurd. Please don't embarrass me or be completely rude. Don't make a fuss about the house, about the food. Whoa, one normal night. I know it's big, but can't you see? This one normal night is for me. Come on.
Fine. Come on.
Right.
Other.
What do you mean they're not right for each other?
What the hell?
Was Napoleon right for Josephine? Was Nasser right for Dramamine? Were the 80s right for the drum machine? Who's to say? Was ballet right for Balanchine? Was polio right for the Salk vaccine? Was school right when the air was not clean? Who's to say? One normal night is a perilous trick. Normal is hard to attain. Children are crazy and parents are quick. Passions are hard to explain. But this is their moment and this is your chance. So if you don't want to remain, start singing of love, 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 only affairs of the heart. Look, the choice is yours. Either you help these kids, or you're stuck here for eternity. So? Yes, right, good. Yes! You got it? So let the normalcy start. Protect and rally round. Let's aid them and all bet. One normal night is what they'll get.
One normal night, one normal night, one normal night. Wednesday wants one normal night, one normal night, one normal night. Give her just one normal night, one normal night, one normal night. Wednesday wants one.
All I want, all I ask,
we'll tend her every need.
When we arrive, we'll come alive to make this night succeed.
Just be respectable, don't make it not remark.
Okay, okay.
Keep undetectable, our passion for the dog.
Just as you said. And then it's paradise right here in Golden Gate Park. In one normal, informal, one normal
here. Oh my God, hurry up!
Hello. We had a little trouble finding the place. It looked like somebody shot out all your street lamps. Wowza. Look at this place. Did they just move in or what?
No! This is how they live in the Bay Area. They spend all their money on rent and can't afford furniture.
Malcolm Beineke. Mm-hmm. And this is why my wife Alice.
Mm-hmm.
And this is my son Lucas.
Mm-hmm.
And you might be who? Oh, nice talking to you.
Earth to Alice, we've landed in Weird City. I say drinks and bye-bye.
Mal, be open to new experience and welcome in the new. Reach deep inside your surprise bag. There might be a gift for you.
Honey, my surprise bag is so full, I can hardly lift it. That guy who patted me down at the airport, he slipped me his cell phone number.
You should be flattered.
I just can't handle any more surprises.
Oh, come on. Lighten up, Dad. These are your type of people. Real salt of the earth.
Really? Where are they from?
Where are we from? Funny you should ask. July 31st, the Spanish warship Pico de Gallo, commanded by my great nautical ancestor, Captain General Redondo Laguna Don Jose Cuervo, leaves Madrid bound for the New World. However, Madrid is 400 miles from the nearest ocean. A stubborn man, he set sail anyway, only to sink off the southern coast of Florida, a hostile land infested with rattlesnakes, mosquitoes, and many retired rich people. Mr. Malcolm Beinecke, I presume, and the lovely Mrs. Malcolm Beinecke. And you must be young Lucas, unless, of course, you are the father, and you are the son with a massive thyroid problem.
I mean...
Oh, I go too far. Anyway, the night she's young. Welcome to our extremely normal home. Gomez Florencia Adams at your service. And now, allow me to present my wife, la dueña, the mother of my children, el amor de mi vida, the love of my life, Morticia.
You were looking again?
Sorry, I'm late. I was putting the apple pie on the windowsill to cool.
That's my little woman, a duchess in the parlor and a genius in the kitchen.
Oh, Gomez.
And a gymnast in the bedroom.
Yes, I'm very talented.
Come on.
So very pleased, Mr.
Mrs.
Beinecke.
Adams.
Mrs. Beinecke.
Call me Alice.
Alice. And you must be Lucas. What a lovely name.
Thanks. I'm named after my uncle Lucas. He got lost in the woods and he ate his own leg.
Oh they don't need to know about that.
Oh,
so.
No. It's a beautiful story. Wednesday has a cousin who swallowed his own tongue. He talked like this. Oh, fuck, a fool, oh, dog, what the fuck?
Thank you, mother.
That's
enough. Hi, I'm Wednesday.
What are you wearing?
A dress.
A yellow dress.
Paloma, what happened? You look like a crime scene.
Would you excuse us for a moment?
Stuffy in here.
I won't have that color in my house.
I'm just being normal, okay?
Darling, we don't wear bright colors. Bright colors are for people with no inner life and no imagination. I'm so sorry. Oh, God. It's everywhere.
It's a lovely yellow dress, Wednesday. Yellow is the color of the warming sun. Yellow is the color of yumminess and fun. Why not show the world the love in which we all wish to receive? Why not wear your heart right on your sleeve where all can see? Yellow.
Excellent! A lovely sentiment about the color yellow. Oh, why look, everyone. It's little Pugsley Adams just returned from Bible study. Say hello, Puggles.
Hello. Want to make a donation?
Of course, sweetheart. What are you collecting for?
Just put some money in the can and no one gets hurt.
God.
Oh. Oh. And this is our dear little grandma, the very heart and soul of our family.
Hi, I just came from the hospital. Cardiac ward. Whew, they're dropping like dead flies over there. I hope you're staying in shape, though, you know. Fresh fruits, grains, 40 minutes on the treadmill.
I know I should, but I'm not doing any of that.
Well, then you're gonna die.
Woo! You're ready for some football.
Football. Football.
Fenton's got the ball. He's running. He's dodging. Look at that sumbitch go. He's on the 20. He's running the third and goal!
And this is my brother, Fester.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, my God.
Thank you, Fester. All right, go away now.
Goodbye.
And now for a toast from the extensive Addams case.
Where's it from?
Children, you're excused.
Lucas, come on. Dad, remember.
Not to worry, Paloma.
Leave the door open, you hear?
Oh, you're just afraid they'll make the beast, huh? Not to worry. My daughter has a black belt in Taekwondo. He tries anything, she'll rip his throat out. To the children.
Excuse me, but do you have a little girl's room?
We used to, but we let them all go.
They let them all go!
Gomez. Come with me, dear. I'll show you. Right this way.
Yes, Morticia. Grand tour for the missus. And me and the mister will go down below for some guy stuff. And then dinner.
And after dinner, the game.
What type of game?
Have you ever played charades?
Yes.
Well, it's nothing like that.
Did you get the flowers I sent you?
Oh, yes. And the lovely poem, wherever did you find it?
Oh, I wrote it!
No.
Yes! When I'm depressed or feeling blessed, a poem gets things off my chest. They come to me, they take no time, they just pop out and always rhyme.
Maybe you should see someone about that.
And they're always about the one thing that everyone needs but so few have.
Healthcare?
Why, love, of course.
Oh.
Let's not talk about anything else but love. Worth repeating. Let's not talk about anything else but love. Can we talk about lofty goals? Let's not talk about anything else.
Wing, your house is huge. You realize they're gonna freak when we tell them.
My father won't.
Why?
Because I already told them.
What? You told your father? Your father? The one with the sword?
He's totally cool with it. Mostly.
I thought you said we were going to tell them all together.
We need his help. You don't know my mother. She could really screw it up.
I'm not marrying your mother.
I know. Look, I know it sounds old-fashioned, but I want their blessing.
You know what? You're right. It is old-fashioned.
Lucas, do you love me?
Of course.
Good. Then leave it to me. It's all going according to plan.
What plan? There is no plan.
That's the plan. Improvise. Keep them guessing.
You're really crazy.
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's a simple dinner. What could go wrong?
A lot.
Come on.
Okay.
Aw. Be patient. And soon the way will be clear. Focus your fear, and troubles all will disappear. Let's not talk about anything old.
Please don't leave us out in the cold.
Let's not talk about anything else but love.
But love.
But love. Thank you.
Interesting chair you got here. Is this some type of antique?
Oh, 15th century, the heretic's chair, once owned by Grand Inquisitor of Madrid, Tomás de Torquemada.
You collect this stuff?
A man must have his hobbies. Some play cards, some play golf. Me, I collect instruments of persuasion. Why, you ask? Go on, ask why.
Why?
Because it's fun! The history of the world told in agony and dismemberment. Get up, let me show you. Yeah, get up. You sit. They ask you a question. They don't like the answer.
In this chair.
That'll make you believe, huh? Sit down, let me ask you a question.
Maybe another time.
Okie dokie. So these crazy kids, huh?
What about them?
They seem very fond of each other, do they not?
Well, sure, but it's not like they're getting married.
No, married, of course not. But they do marry young these days.
Well, I'm not sure what they do.
Right. Well then, tell me about you, the Beineke saga, your lies, your hopes, your dreams, your son.
Lucas, yeah, he's a little soft, like his mother. But when he gets out of college, I'll teach him the business. You know, make him a man.
Malcolm, may I say something? You and I feel this connection. Do you feel this?
No.
Forgive me, Jesus, for I have sinned.
So I see you got all these pictures. Who's in this one?
Oh, that's just my step-grandfather's second uncle's cousin.
I was a member of the court of King Louis the 14th, King Louis the Sun God. One of the highest officials of them all. And then, one day, a cannonball.
They're up every time.
Well, what about this one?
Oh, that's just my oldest ancestor, Roca Addams.
I live. Rocco. I dead.
Rock on.
He wasn't very smart.
Interesting. So tell me, Addams, 10,000 square feet, right in the middle of a public park. How did you swing this place?
It has been in my family for many centuries, ever since Queen Isabella of Spain deeded it to my great ancestor, Alfonso the Fantastic. For services rendered.
What type of services?
You know, tiny but mighty. Come, Beineke, let me show you the moat. Did you bring a bathing suit?
Bathing suit?
Oh, never mind. Let's be crazy.
I'm not really good at crazy.
Yes, you absolutely have to take a look at our family photo album.
I can't wait.
Yes, it's simply to die for. All right, now let's see who we got. Okay, now these two are my cousins.
You're serious?
Of course. It's fun.
Great.
Yes, okay. These two are my aunties.
Wasn't your son at Bible study earlier?
Of course. We love God.
Oh, God.
Yes, it's fun. Okay, this is my cousin, twice removed.
Twice removed?
Well, they removed it once, but then it grew back. I'm just kidding, this isn't Hedwig.
Oh.
My name was Alexandria the Second. I wandered into the jungle, and I never came back.
Mysterious.
Yes, we think it was the snake our family had released earlier that day, but who knows? All right, these three are my great aunties.
feminism.
Yes. Okay, Gomez's cousin. We love sisterhood.
Sisterhood.
Yeah. Anyway. All right. Who do we have? Okay. Gomez's cousin.
Hi. My name's Annabelle, and I was a flounder from the 1860s. And I fell in love with this one guy who told me he loved me. But then he cheated. He cheated. I snitched. It was great. And I just snitches got stitches. The bullets.
Maybe next time he should think before he cheats.
Perhaps. All right, these two are my third cousins.
My name is Carmen, and I'm Angelina. And me and my sister are rivaling to be the best detectives in the world. But of course, I have better. So, I kill her.
Great.
Yes, it's marvelous. All right,
over here.
Oh, that's Gomez's fourth cousin.
At least she has a good sense of humor.
Oh, yes, we love laughter and death. Anyway, that's my mother.
That's your mother?
Yes, it's fun. Anyway, these two, okay. Related to me and not Gomez, just saying.
This is quite problematic.
It's so fun.
Yeah. Oh, what's this?
That is Gomez and me at our wedding.
Oh, how beautiful.
Yes, look at the skull. Isn't it cute?
Yeah.
It's my uncle's.
Even better.
Yes.
Oh, over here.
Our wedding vows.
How romantic.
Yes.
We promise to tango at least 3 times a week.
For passion.
We promise to tell each other everything.
For truth.
Everything?
Of course.
Boy, sure doesn't work that way in my household.
How does it work?
Well, what's good for the gander is a nice quiet goose. If I told Mal my secrets, all hell would break loose.
Alice, I'm shocked. What kind of marriage is it where you keep secrets from each other?
A long one.
Secrets are the enemies of passion. Speaking true will get you through the day. Truth is not a thing that one should ration, but I think you think of it that way. Never keep a sin inside the closet. Always give the facts a fighting chance. Every time you do, it's a deposit in the long-term life of your romance. Keep no secret if you want to remain your lover. Share all secrets. There's worlds of things you might discover. Truth is beauty. He should always know exactly who you are. Bear your secret, and your marriage will be healthier by far. Gomez adores me, never ignores me, always has put me first. And Alice, if he should try once telling a lie once, I'd throw him out head first. Reeling, he'd plead, I reconsider. Kneeling, he'd quickly start to drown. Begging me for lenience, but at my first convenience, I'd put him on the first bus out of town.
Morticia, is Gomez truly devoted? Never misquoted, always a paragon.
Without a doubt.
And if he told you a lie, you'd whisper goodbye, then leave him to carry on.
That's it exactly.
Is there no room for some discussion?
If Gomez lied?
Is there no chance?
might forgive.
A lie's a lie and lies can kill. And life can quickly go downhill. She kept a secret and she wound up on the guillotine.
Now I see what you mean.
She kept a secret and they shot her with an M16.
That's not a pretty scene.
She kept a secret and she wound up on the cover of a magazine. She's quite the Philistine.
What's this one?
The dance routine. No, no, bad. Off the furniture. Off. Off. What are you doing? Ah, come with me, dear. Keep no secrets. Welcome honesty with no resistance. Then your marriage is a loving kind of coexistence. Lies and secrets, they're the sins that keep a husband from a wife. Gomez loves me, he would never keep a secret in his life.
So, where does a student get the money for an engagement ring?
Well, after school, I'd work at the bookstore, and on weekends, I tutor kids at a charter school, and then over the summer, I work at my uncle's grocery store.
Is any of this true?
Most of it.
And in your time off, wise guy?
I think about Wednesday. And how much I love her, and how we could have a wonderful life together.
And what does a Lucas Beineke become when he grows up?
Maybe a writer, or a medical examiner.
A medical examiner, why?
Because then you can look inside people's bodies, and they don't mind because they're dead.
Where did you find him?
We just found each other. It's sort of a miracle. Oh my god, Daddy.
What are we gonna do?
Let's just tell her it'll all be okay.
Daddy, you promised after dinner.
Yeah, I know.
What about Baker at 1?
I'm gonna talk about.
What are you talking about?
The news. I thought you two headquarters were shooting there. The weather. I heard it was gonna rain.
Maybe the stars are at number 1.
Okay. We're gonna go now.
Come, Lucas. Let me show you the moat. Have you ever seen a rat as big as a dachshund?
No, sir.
Gomez?
Yes?
What were you doing?
Oh, we were just talking.
That wasn't talking. That was conspiring.
Oh, no, no, no. Conspiring's like this. She's here.
That's what you were doing.
Querida, stop this voice.
You're keeping something from me.
Querida, if I am keeping something from you, may lightning strike me right where I stand.
To think it should come to this.
God, I feel an urge to take you to my
house. No, Gomez.
But you've never turned down a trip to heaven.
Not today. I'll be in my room until you're ready to share like a proper husband.
Morticia mia. Like a bug in a jar or a frozen cable car, I'm trapped. Like a man growing gray when his wife says not today. What if she doesn't dance with me anymore? Who would conceive it? What if I and one tiny lie started civil war? What if a line's been crossed? Vows a commitment lost. How is that possible? Could that be possible?
Stupid. God, I hate Lucas. I hate him.
Why?
After dinner.
Yeah, but what if they hate each other?
What if they don't? Be like me. Look on the bright side.
You make me so crazy. I love it.
Pugsley. Stop sneaking around like that.
It's my house too, okay?
Excuse me while I kill my brother.
I got this.
Hey, it's the Pugster. What's up, little man?
You trying to be cool?
Uh-huh.
Because you're not cool.
Your sister thinks I am.
She'll get over it.
Aren't you a little young to be smoking?
I'm under a lot of stress. My sister's having an identity crisis.
Okay, we're gonna go now.
Can I come?
Sorry, Pugs. I'm with Lucas now. Bye!
But wait. Wait. What if she never tortures me anymore? How would I manage? What if she never nails my tongue to the bathroom floor? What if she walks away, leaving me a-okay, hiding each power tool? Why would she be so cruel? I could stab my arm myself, could rip my tonsils out, could set my hair aflame. I could spray my eyes with mace, but face the fact, without her, it wouldn't be the same. Hi, Grandma.
Dad, how's life?
Too long.
What?
I said too long.
Shut up. No. Okay.
Okay.
No. Sorry. Here's what you need to do. Idiot.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and dance and smile and sing. If you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and a whistle, that's the thing. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life.
I get it, Grandma.
Ooh. Still got it.
Hold on. What are you doing?
Well, you know, just restocking. Grandma's private stash. Herbs, potions, and remedies. Nature's candy. No prescription needed. Not like a drug addict or anything.
What's this one?
Ah, that is peyote.
What's it do?
You know, the normal stuff. Just makes you run around naked in the woods. Once, twice.
What about this one?
That is buku leaf. You got someone giving you a hard time, kid?
Maybe.
Well, just sprinkle a little bit of this on her toast, and an hour later, she's in a padded room screaming, I am Spartacus!
Grandma, what if there was this girl who met this person, and he's all like, hey, it's the Pugster! What's up, little man? And she's all like, golly, and we're gonna go now. And they're running away together. What would you give her?
Well, nothing. She's your sister. Be happy for her.
But what if she doesn't get rid of him? What if the good times are already behind me?
That's life, kid. You lose the thing you love.
Tell me about it. What about this one?
No. Put that back. No. That is acrimonium. You do not want to mess with that.
Why?
That takes the lid off the id. It brings out the dark side.
What do you mean?
That make Mary Poppins turn into Madea.
I don't understand your references.
Well, then stop your damn texting and pick up a book for once in a while. You know, the ones with the pages, yeah.
Yeah.
And stop worrying about your sister and start thinking about what you're gonna do. Time, my dear, is a thief. She'll steal your soul and fleon little fairy wings. Hmm. And stay out of my shit or I will rip your legs off and bury you in the backyard. Do you understand?
Yeah, Grandma.
Okay, I love you.
Another magnificent feast, all thanks to my fabulous lady wife from whom I keep nothing. This dinner puts me in mind of my great ancestor.
Thank you, dear. And now it's time to play the game.
Please not the game, it's really late.
Darling.
Pugsley, would you go away and die?
I will if your boyfriend will.
Gotta. Maybe the game's a bad idea.
No, it's a good idea. And if it isn't, well, then somebody will be sleeping on the couch for a very long time.
Actually, it's a great idea, the best of all ideas. I'm sorry.
What kind of game?
We call it obligación de revelar.
What does it mean?
Full disclosure.
Yes, everyone sips from the sacred family chalice.
And confesses a secret they've never told anyone.
Loosely based on the Inquisition.
And you have to absolutely tell the truth.
Or what?
Or there are consequences.
I don't think I'd be very good at that game.
Well, sure you would, honey.
No.
And now Gomez will break the ice. My husband has something he needs to disclose.
No, the host goes last.
Large, the sacred, oh, there you are. The sacred chalice.
This is a sacred chalice from Addams family's past. Firm in my digitalis, held fast, die cast. Here in a sweet libation, salvation resides. Feel the sweet sensation revelation provides. Full disclosure, it's a game that we play. Let your darkest secrets give you away. Face your demons and then happily say, I'm playing full disclosure with all these crazy happy people.
Full disclosure.
It's a hell of a thing. Once the favorite of the late Deng Xiaoping. Doesn't matter if you're right or left wing, he loves his full disclosure.
Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure.
Disclosure, full disclosure, full disclosure.
Yes, well, my disclosure is in the form of a fairy tale. Once there was a humble man with a beautiful wife and two beautiful children. A humble man, I say, yet within his breast beat the heart of a loyal and steadfast husband who treasured his wife and worshipped the ground she walked on. Thank you. And one day, a fox appeared to the man with a box of beautiful wood and rare Spanish leather. What's in the box? Asked the kindly man. And the fox said, a little secret, nothing important, but you must never open it. And the kindly man took the box home to his wife, and she said, "Let's open it anyways." And the kindly man said, "Don't push it, honey. We've got a good thing going." So you know what? They never did open the box, and they all lived happily ever after. Full disclosure.
Well, we'll just have to come back to you then, won't we? Wednesday's turn.
Pass.
Ooh. Oh, yes, let's hear from Fester, the chalice.
I am in love.
Aww.
You're probably wondering, what does a fat, bald man of no specific sexuality know about love? But I, too, am in love. Fester loves.
Oh, Fester, who is it?
The moon.
Aww. The moon! He's in love with the moon.
Yeah, that's normal.
That's the most beautiful thing I've ever heard.
Oh, I haven't told her yet. Full disclosure. Full disclosure, just embrace it and swoon.
Embrace and swoon.
Fall from grace or fall in love with the moon.
He loves that moon.
Close your sermon with a signature tune and call it full disclosure.
Wednesday's turn.
No, me. Age before beauty. And the chalice.
Oh, no. Cover your ears, Lucas.
Leave some for the rest of us.
So, the kid and I had a little heart-to-heart earlier. I told him to use his time wisely. Still, look who's talking. I'm 102 years old. I got shingles and arthritis. And when I break wind, it can start the windmills on an old Dutch painting. Still, I got one more round left in me. Call me cougar, but five will catch you 10. There's a couple of 95-year-old hotties out there just waiting to chow down on a grandma sandwich.
Oh, full disclosure. Still single, right?
Full disclosure.
Never mind.
Well, I told you so. God damn it.
We should have put you down years ago. All right. Wednesday's turn.
Not yet. Daddy, talk to her.
I've still got the fox problem.
Wednesday, your turn. Get on with it. The chalice. Where's the chalice?
Yes. Now with the dash of potion, my sister blows her cool. Hopefully in slow motion, she'll drool. One sip of acrimonium, and then she will change. Boy, oh boy, her full disclosure's gonna be strange.
Full disclosure.
It's the moment.
La 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 la.
Now you better hit the truth like Babe Ruth.
La 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 la.
This is torture like an impacted tube.
Full.
No.
As you can see, my wife really isn't herself, so we'll be on our way.
No! We're in the middle of a game! So button your lip and sit your ass back down!
Alice, I think you've had enough to drink.
Remember how it used to be, Mal? Back when we would look at each other from across the table in the middle of dinner, and we'd get in the car and rush home and go upstairs, and sometimes you couldn't even wait, and you would just pull the car over to the side of the road!
Mom!
Lighten up, Lucas! Parents, do it! Live with it! Remember how it used to be, Mal? Back when we were crazy, and the future didn't exist? What happened, Mal? The guy with the Grateful Dead t-shirt? Is he ever coming back? How long do I have to keep waiting? A woman waits for marriage. A woman waits for children. She waits for her big Mal to come back home. At 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock, till it's 9 o'clock and there's no o'clock to ease the pain. waiting and waning, whining and wasting, wanting and wasting and woe. Waiting, fixating, debating, lose waiting, ice skating, lactating, and so we wait to laugh. We wait to cry. We wait for every hopeful breath. Waiting for a lousy, rotting, vicious, rancid, flushed down, fetid, frenzied fatal
death. That was too dark even for us.
Full disclosure.
Wow, that story was grim.
We're talking grim.
Filled with fear and loathing up to the brim.
That's quite a brim.
Just imagine being married to him.
Okay, Addams. I've had enough. I tried. I really tried. I thought the kids like each other. Let's give it a shot. But you people are insane. You got a house where there shouldn't be a house. You got a zombie for a butler and a man who's dating the moon.
Oh, I wouldn't exactly say we're dating.
Look, we're simple people, Mr. Addams. We're not used to your sophisticated San Francisco lifestyle. So with your permission, we're gonna go back to the real America. Full disclosure. Lucas, help your mother off the table.
You were right, Lucas.
Right about what?
Thanks anyway, Daddy.
Thanks for what?
We should have just told her.
Told me what?
It doesn't matter.
Ouch.
Lucas and I love each other, and we're getting married.
What?
What?
That's what you kept from me?
Married.
No secrets, huh?
Yes, we kept a secret.
And you kept it from me.
So we're getting married.
Are they getting married? Married, 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 married? Full disclosure, what a miserable game! Play it once and life is never the same. So I'm not sorry, it's for someone to blame. Enough of
this. This is enough of enough of this. Can't be happening. Stop!
Never fails. You let nature take its course. Chaos. I mean, is this any way to end an act?
Yeah.
Actually, yes. But it'd be better if the guests couldn't leave just yet. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Okay, dead people, give me some weather.
Tornado! We'll never make it out alive!
Well, Beinekes, looks like you'll be spending the night. That's what happens when you play.
Oh!